Hello everyone, and welcome to this Moodle Academy webinar, What's New in Moodle 4.3? I'm Mary Cooch, Education Manager at Moodle HQ, and I'm going to be taking you through the presentation. And I have with me UX Analyst at Moodle HQ, Helen Foster. Helen, if you'd like to say hello.
Hello everyone, nice to be here.
So Helen is going to be monitoring the chat and then relaying the questions at intervals during the presentation. So feel free to ask any questions about Moodle 4.3 that you have in the chat. So here goes. The way we're going to do it is like this. So we're going to divide the presentation into two sections. What's new in site administration? Then we'll have a little break to cover any questions you might have about site administration in 4.3. And then what's new in courses for course teachers. Hopefully then we will have some time at the end to cover more questions about 4.3. There is a lot. There's a lot that's new and a lot that hopefully you will appreciate. So here's my list of what's new for site administration. And we're going to take them a few at a time. We're going to look, first of all, at the big improvements and integrations of communication. We're going to look at a new feature thanks to the Moodle Users Association, which is site level activity completion settings. And then we're going to start looking at improvements to LTI external tool. Some of the things you'll see in admin continue into courses for course teachers, as you'll see now. So let's begin with communication matrix. Now, matrix is one way of messaging students. And if you enable communication providers from site administration development experimental settings, then you will be able as an admin, if you want to and if you know how to install a matrix server and to connect it to your Moodle site so that your learners and teachers can have a matrix room for discussing the course automatically in their course. You see, we have a screenshot here. This setting will appear, manage communication providers. And if you have matrix enabled, because you've got your own matrix server, then you click settings and you can add the details of your particular server. What happens then when matrix rooms are created, and we'll look at this as a course teacher when we go into it in the course settings, then the teacher automatically has the role of the moderator in the matrix room. And when the learners click to go into the room, their user accounts are also created. Now, that might not necessarily be something that as an administrator you can do or you want to do. So there's also another possibility that I really like, which is called custom link. Now, custom link, if you choose to keep it enabled, means that, again, from the same place in the course, a teacher can add a link to either an existing matrix room that they've been using with their class or a room in another messaging service, such as Slack, Telegram, for example. And you can use that to discuss with your learners. And there's a neat little icon enabling them to go directly to that messaging while they're in the course. So we'll take more look at that when we're in the course settings, but let's move on. And we're now going to look at the Moodle Users Association project of site level activity completion settings. And for this, there is a new section in site administration, courses, default setting. And there's a new page called default activity completion. Now, the reason for this is as follows. Previously, the activity completion defaults were manual, which wasn't ideal, for example, if you were a heavy user of text and media areas, otherwise known as labels. And teachers then would change the defaults to whatever suited them. Now, because we have this new site page, administrators, after discussion with the teaching staff, can define sensible defaults for each of the activities. And we have this page, which is the same page as a teacher already has because the teachers in courses can already change the default completion. It's been made much more attractive and easy to manage. But from here, an administrator can define the defaults, which probably most teachers will usually want to use, so they don't have to change everything every time they create a new activity. Now, we're going to come back to this with another exciting, to me, I'm very excited about this feature when we look at course settings. Now, next is external tool. Now, LTI external tools have been significantly refactored in Moodle 4.3. Most of the work is involved in courses for what teachers can do and how teachers manage LTI external tools. So we're going to look at that in detail later. But as an administrator, one thing that is going to be beneficial to you is that if you, from the site admin settings, if you add an external tool, you now have a new setting to restrict it to a particular category or categories, so that it's only available to teachers where it would be useful. So for example, ChemVantage, that's an LTI tool, you could restrict that so it would only appear for teachers to use in if you had a sciences category or a chemistry category, because it's not much point to be in a humanities or a language category. So that's something new for administrators, and we'll look at much more when we look at it for teachers. Okay, back in our list of what's new, we're now going to take a look at a new filter which you can enable. Improvements to TinyMCE, which, as you know, is now the default editor and will completely replace the previous Atto editor. And then improvements to the report builder for you to create custom reports. Now, you see here, we are in filters from site administration, plugins, filters. And if you enable a new filter called code highlighter, this will then color code, making it easier for people to use. Now, this is separate from another feature, which is new in TinyMCE, but both of these allow for easier viewing and managing of code. So if we go and look at what's new in TinyMCE, there's a full screen option now, so teachers can click a button to see the have it type as full screen. And for you, the admin from TinyMCE editor general settings, there's the option Tiny Premium, which makes it easy for you to add the settings if you've purchased a subscription to Tiny Premium. This is one of our certified integration partners. And then Tiny HTML formatter, which will again make code indent nicely. And Tiny No Auto Link, which is something that I think will be useful. I have a couple of screenshots of these. So here, we're in a normal TinyMCE editor, and our teacher has added an enormous image of an elephant. This is a demonstration course, Effective Memory Techniques. And you see that there is an icon to click to view all of this full screen. Additionally, the other new button or icon is like an exclamation mark. You can see it there. And if you have something which is linked, but you don't want it to be linked, then you can select it and you can choose no auto link. Okay. Now, every time we have a new version of Moodle LMS, improvements come in for the report builder, allowing you to create custom reports. Report builder is a great example of how Workplace, which is a paid version of Moodle, always feeds back into LMS some of its great features. And the report builder came into Moodle LMS in recent versions and is improved each time. So this time we have a new report source, which is course categories. You can filter by enrollment name and context level. And I'll show you an example of that, how this can create really useful reports. And the participants report actually includes course completion column, criteria column, and entities enrollment method and enrollment. Incidentally, If you go on our YouTube channel or you look in our documentation, there are 6 videos which demonstrate these new features, including Report Builder. So if we go to Site Administration and Reports, and we click to add a new report, you see here alongside the list of all the other existing report sources, you can now create a report for course categories. Here, we are creating a report file storage by course. And we can do this because of the new context level reporting. And you see that here we've got the list of our courses in the course column with the number of files, that's the count there, and the total size. So this will be very useful for you to see which courses actually are very, very heavy on file size. You can also do this by user. File storage by user, and the video on YouTube demonstrates how to do this. So you can find out which of your teaching staff or your learners have a lot of files there. Okay, now moving on in new Site Administration, we're going to look at security improvements, an improvement to badges. And then for those of you who are site administrators who maybe adapt roles and so on, updates to the capabilities. Now, security improvements, I have to say, not all of these lend themselves to attractive screenshots, so they won't all have screenshots, but it's very important to tell you what they are. Now, multi-factor authentication is something that has been brought in. It was originally a plugin, and that perhaps many of you are aware of or used, and has been brought in and adapted for Moodle LMS. Now, the adaptations for this version relate mainly to the user view. There will be more improvements in the next version from the admin point of view. You can have a recapture on the login page, web service tokens, read only once. If you use a lot of videos from YouTube or Vimeo, you might like the do not tracking option, and several others. I won't read them, but you'll be able to download this presentation afterwards as well as watching the recording. So hopefully they will be useful to you there. Let's just have a look at a few of these then. Multi-factor authentication, you will find this in admin tools. And if you click to manage MFA, here you can select the factor or the ways in which people will have to authenticate. Now, for example, and their weight, their number of points. For example, I've highlighted here authenticator app. In some of our Moodle HQ sites, we use this. It means that with this enabled, you can't log in unless you go to your mobile phone and you get a code which comes on an authenticator app. And you enter that. That's just one example, for instance. You can also authenticate if you're a member of a particular cohort. That's something we use on Academy, for instance. And you need to make sure that it's enabled. If you go to the Manage Authentication page in Site Administration, there's a new setting there, Enable Recapture for Login. And you can see over there on the right-hand side, our student is going to have to do that before she can log in. Also, and this is very important for web services, if you've got a token, but if you forget it or whatever reason, it is only shown once for security reasons, and then a new one, you need to copy it and use it, but then a new one can be created. Now, this one, YouTube and Vimeo, they both have their own pages in Site Administration. Although they use different wordings, basically both of these will allow you to check a box so that session data is not tracked. Okay. Now we're going to look at improvements to badges for site administrators. So you can now tag badges. And the way that you connect to backpacks is improved. And also something I would like to show you, which is that if you have a lot of site badges, then you can now search and filter them. So if as a site administrator, you go to your Manage Badges page, you will see that you can filter For instance, you can filter from not available, or you can filter by name, and that makes it very easy for you to find a particular badge that you would need. Site badges, that is. And finally, for administrators, then we'll have a little break and see if there are any comments or questions. We always like to show you which capabilities have gone and which are new capabilities in a new version of Moodle. Now, the removed capability relates to Moodle, relates to LTI external tools. That's because, as I've already explained, and we'll look in more detail in a moment, the whole system of adding LTI external tools and managing them has been refactored. In the new capabilities, you might notice things like communication, matrix moderator, course communication. These, of course, relate to the course communication with matrix or other messaging services. There are also capabilities relating to sharing courses, and we're going to look at MoodleNet and improvements to MoodleNet there as well. So that's what's new in site administration. And I'm just going to stop presenting for a moment. And I'm going to ask Helen, how are we doing for any questions? I can't see the chat while I'm presenting, or any comments before we move on to what's new in courses.
We just have a couple of questions so far in the chat, Mary. The first one was from Scott asking, how does TinyMC recognize code? Is it certain characters typed or a button in the user interface? And I answered, there's a code button, which is in the format menu in TinyMC.
Yes, yeah, okay.
And then Tina asked, is badge import still impossible?
Oh, okay. Are you asking about the fact that there have been problems with exporting your badges to an external site like Badger? If that's correct, then my understanding is that Moodle HQ has worked on it as much as they can, but the problem is related to the fact that I believe Canvas or Instructure have bought Badger, and we need to rely on them for certain other settings. There is a tracker issue that it might be possible to add that you can follow the progress of this. I haven't followed it this week, but okay. Ah, okay. Well, I've given you some extra unasked for information there about badges, but Tina is saying no, copying them to another course. I think you can copy them if you include user data, but I'm not sure. I don't know. Do you know about that, Helen?
No, I'm not sure. I'd have to look and see if there's a tracker issue on it.
Yes, or if you're available to select badges when you import into another course or backup and restore. I can't remember, but that would be quite an easy one for us to check for you.
Otherwise, do feel free to ask on Moodle.org in the there's a badges forum there, and they'd surely have the answer there.
Okay. Is there anything else, or shall we move on to what's new in courses?
John's just mentioning this on Moodle Academy. You can show badges from another site. That's talking about before.
Ah, yes. Okay. Okay. Shall we move on then?
Sounds good.
Right. So from what's new in site administration, we're now going to look at what's new in courses. Slightly fewer bullet points, but a lot more information, actually. There's a lot new in courses, and we're going to begin with a redesign of the activity cards. I'll explain that term in a moment. And looking more at activity completion, you recall there's a new page for setting site-level activity completion defaults. Going to look a bit more at that. Now, activity cards redesign. The activity cards are basically the little sections where you have your activity or resource and any kind of completion, tracking or restrict access in them. And previously, they were quite wide, and people complained that they took up a lot of screen space. So they're now narrower. Also, the icons that represent the activities are smaller. They were quite large. And if you have restricted activities, there's a neater way of showing those that uses less space. Group mode icons have reappeared in a very clever way, I think. And basically, the conditions for completion and for restriction are more compact and easily configurable for the teacher from the course page. Now, to look at these, I think a good way of doing it is to compare and contrast with what we had previously in Moodle 4.2. So what you're seeing in this screenshot is a student in a course in Moodle 4.2. And so these are the activity cards in which you have an icon and the name of an activity or resource. And over on the right, you have the completion condition buttons. And for example, Module 2 Quick Check, which is a quiz, it says that a student has to do this. She has to receive a grade. She has to receive a passing grade. And now if we look at the exact same student in the exact same course, but in Moodle 4.3, well, first of all, you'll notice that there are more activity cards on my screenshot because they are narrower. The activity icons are smaller. And where it says what she has to do in Module 2 Quick Check, it's actually in a neat little to-do drop-down, and she just clicks it to see what she has to do, and then she can click it again, and it's not disrupting her view of the course. Now, this neatness is also reflected in restrict access. This is Moodle 4.2 with our same student, and the end of course summative assignment, she can only access it if there are three particular restrictions there, and she's got to click to show more. And that does use up a lot of screen space. Okay, now, if we go and look at the same end of course summative assignment in Moodle 4.3, this is how it looks. So as with the completion conditions, she has a little drop down and it says show more. And when she clicks show more, then she can see all of the conditions, the restrictions, and then she clicks show less again, and it doesn't appear, so that her course page is nice and neat. Now, there are similar improvements from the teacher point of view. So we're going to go straight into a Moodle 3 course for a Moodle 4.3 course to show you what the teacher has, rather than comparing and contrasting. And this screenshot is divided into two. In the top here, you can see that Module 1 formative check, there's nothing there. But if our teacher with edit mode enabled, and if we look at number 2, the bottom section here, if he hovers his cursor over there, then an icon appears to say, oh, well, there's no groups. So this is how he can see whether groups are there, and he simply needs to click it. And he has the option of making it visible groups or separate groups. Or if he clicks an existing icon, again, a modal window will open up to change it to no groups if necessary. So here's an example of an activity that supports groups, because of course, you will only see the group icon if it's something that supports groups. So here we have a forum called Course Coffee Shop, and he's clicked. This icon is saying that he has visible groups, but when he clicks the icon, then he can change it to no groups or separate groups. It's a very neat way of doing it. Only teachers see this, not students. He can also access groups from the menu on the right, the three dots there. And this is also useful for some other new settings, one called availability. So if he clicks availability, this allows him to show, hide, or make available but not show on the course page. That is related to what we call stealth mode, if you know about that or you use that. So that's a quick way of changing the availability of a single item on the course page. And for instance, if he chooses to hide it, then he can quickly change its availability directly on the course page simply by clicking the arrow underneath that item. And this is something that is very new and very useful for teachers in terms of editing the course page. So, for instance, in this screenshot, Module 1 formative check, when he clicks completion, he can see what the student has to do to complete this, so he's aware of that. But also, if he wanted to change the completion conditions, he simply needs to click Edit Conditions, and this would take him directly to the activity completion settings in that activity or resource, so he can change them there. So there is no need to click on the activity and then scroll all the way down the page to edit the conditions. He can go straight there, change them, and come out again. And the same edit directly on the course page appears when you're using restrict access. So here we have a final test and we have end of course feedback form. Both of these, underneath them, it says edit restrictions. And so again, if he clicks edit restrictions, he's taken directly into the edit restriction, restrict access section of that activity. He can change them there and then save and come back out again. So this is a great time saver for the teacher. Now, continuing with the benefits for the teacher, we're looking at activity completion. And as you recall, this was a Moodle Users Association sponsored project to improve the default completion page. And so we've looked that for site administrators, there is a new page where they can specify sensible activity completion defaults for each of the activities. But there's something more, and again, that is going to help teachers when editing their courses. So the teacher also has, as a matter of fact, from more course completion, they can select default activity completion. And they've got that page, the same as the teacher, where they can change the defaults for their courses. But they might probably won't need to do that now if the administrator has set sensible defaults. But if you look and if we click assignment, for instance, the way they select activity completion has changed, and you're not actually seeing everything, all the conditions. So let's take a look at this a step at a time by imagining our teacher is creating an activity and wants to set activity completion. So first of all, when they go to completion conditions within that activity, they'll only see three options. None, students must manually mark the activity as done, and then add requirements. If they click add requirements, then and only then in my number two screenshot, do the requirements for that particular activity or course become visible. So for example, if our teacher selected receive a grade, then, and if you look at my number three, only then will the options any grade or a passing grade appear. So this is what we call progressive display of conditions, which again makes the helps the cognitive overload, if you like, of the teacher, not too much information on the course page at once. Because if they only want, for example, students to mark the activity as done, they don't need to see on the page all of the other options. Now, let's move on and look again at course communication. So that was the feature involving matrix integration, but also allowing teachers to use or to link to other messaging services. The significant enhancements to how teachers add and manage LTI external tools. And a big fan of this, MoodleNet. You can now share whole courses in MoodleNet. So let's start with course communication. Now, from the More tab, and be warned, there is a lot in the More tab for teachers. The More tab is very busy in Moodle 4.3. So here, the teacher can select More Communication. If a matrix room has been created, automatically created in a new course for a teacher, they can give it a name here, they can give it a topic. If you don't give your room a name, then it will take the name from your course. But supposing the administrator isn't using a matrix server, that doesn't matter because as a teacher, you can change provider and instead of matrix, you can select custom link, assuming the admin still has that enabled, give it a name, and then you add a URL to a messaging place or room that you can use with your learners. This one is an instance of a Telegram room, for example. Then when you click Save Changes, your room is ready. It will be immediately made because it already exists. And if you look next to my number two, this blue icon here, which does follow you around as you're going through the course, this is where you, the teacher, and your students will be able to click to go into the, in our case, Telegram room, or the room that whichever you've added to the custom link. So this is a really good way of enabling you and your learners to chat in a modern messaging service, but still be in your Moodle course. Now, I said the more tab is very busy, and we're going back there again now, and this time we're going down to LTI external tools. And there's a lot of explanation needed to how teachers add and manage LTI external tools. Let's click this link, and it takes us to a completely new page for adding and managing tools. Now, the most important thing to explain here, and I'll repeat it again later, is that you no longer, as a teacher, when you go into your course and you click on the activity chooser, you no longer see the option external tool. That's gone. If you want to add an external tool, you've arranged it with a company, for instance, and you've got the settings that they've given you, you go to this page and you click add tool and you add your settings there. What you'll also see here is existing tools either added by you, and in which case, if you've added them, then you can click the actions to edit them or delete them, or added by the administrator, in which case you'd see a padlock and you wouldn't be able to edit or delete them. But you can also, and this is useful, you can also see how often they're used, and you can toggle Show in Activity Chooser. What this means is that you, the teacher, can decide whether a tool that's on this page is actually available to be added in the activity chooser or not. Now, in our case, we've added an external tool, LMR Memo Learn, and we've decided, yeah, we want to show that in the activity chooser because we want to be able to add an instance of it in our course. But this elementary school Mount Orange, the admin added that, and it's not really relevant to us. So we don't want to see it in the activity chooser. So we've toggled, and you can see it's gray there, we've toggled to not show it. So if we go to the activity chooser, add an activity or resource, first of all, I challenge you to try to find external tool. It's not there because you don't add external tools from there anymore. We can see LMR Memo Learn, and we could add that. But we can't see the other one that the admin added, Mount Orange, because we decided not to show it in the activity chooser. So when you add a tool from here, basically all you have to do is simply give it a name and a description and then any other settings that you need, and that's it. So all of the difficult work of adding the settings that you got from the company to add it, that you do from more LTI external tools. In the activity chooser, you just add, as you can see here, its name, description, and anything else. And then it appears on your course page. Okay, back to the more tab. As I said, this is a very, very busy area now. So we've gone from communication to LTI external tools. We also go here if we want to share to MoodleNet. So previously in Moodle 4.2, you could actually share individual activities in MoodleNet. If it was enabled by the admin, not all admins might have done this, but if they have, then you clicked into an activity and then from the More tab, you could share to MoodleNet. Now you can share whole courses. So if we click share to MoodleNet, then it will give you the whole course and you click share. And assuming you've got an account on MoodleNet and you're logged into MoodleNet, it will upload your whole course into MoodleNet as a draft. So it's not visible, it's not public until you go to MoodleNet, check everything, and then decide to publicly share it. And that's a really useful feature, which I hope a lot of people will use if they have good courses which are worth sharing. Now, you might want to share some parts of your course, but not all of them. For instance, you might have a course where you've got lots of useful activities, but there are two or three that relate to your learners only that wouldn't really be very helpful to people around the world looking at MoodleNet. So if you want to share parts of a course, then as a teacher, you enable edit mode, and then you click the newly renamed bulk actions. This used to be bulk edit in English. In English now, it's changed to bulk actions. And you can select the items in the course that you want to share. Then in the sticky footer at the bottom, if you've seen our previous videos, What's New In, you'll notice that this appeared, enabling you to bulk edit availability, duplicate, move and delete. We now have share to MoodleNet. So everything that you've selected will then be bundled up and shared to MoodleNet. And it will take you to the same place as before, where it will be uploaded as draft so that you can check everything before making it public. And there is also a page in the More tab where you can actually see the send progress of items that you're sharing to make sure everything's working well. Goodness me, we have a lot, and there's a lot more to come. We're going to look now at gradebook enhancements and improvements to the question bank, and then what I've grouped together as other, and there's quite a lot of other. Okay, for the gradebook, we don't have screenshots for all of these, but all of these I hope you'll appreciate. There are sticky footers in various places for quick access to buttons. As a teacher, you can view in the user report in the single view, you can view icons that show things which are locked or hidden. When you're in the gradebook setup, if you want to add a grade item or edit it or a category, they will open up in a modal window so you don't lose the gradebook behind. And there is improved overriding of weights. I think we have a couple of screenshots to demonstrate these. So here, we're in a user report viewing it as the student, Barbara, and you can see that you can easily move from to the next student or the previous student from these very fashionable, they're appearing everywhere now, sticky footers. In the next screenshot, we're in a user report, Paula, but this time we're viewing it as the teacher. It says myself, that means the teacher. And a couple of these grade items here are hidden, but the teacher can actually see that they're hidden because they can see the hidden icon. Now, if as a teacher, you wanted to add a new grade item, so you were in the gradebook setup, when you click to add a new grade item, it opens in a modal window. You can do all of the things you need to do, save it, and you're still in the gradebook setup behind you. Now, question bank improvements, and these, again, this is a great example of improvements to Moodle LMS Core that have been contributed by communities rather than HQ developers. There's better searching and filtering in your course question bank, and you as a teacher can customize the view of the question bank. This is something I've already done in my own courses, and I very much like it. So if we go to a question bank, this is our course, Effective Memory Techniques, which is a demonstration course for Moodle 4.3. And if I haven't added it to MoodleNet already, I will do so this week. It's already available for you to play around with on school.moodledemo.net, by the way. In the question bank of this new course, you can see that the searching and filtering is similar to the way other areas in a course, such as participants, allow you to search and filter. And at the very bottom of the screenshot, you might be wondering, well, what are all of these edit icons, these cogs, what's this all about? So if we go to the next screenshot and look at these larger, now each of these is a column in the question bank that you as the teacher can, if you just click, you can move that column, remove it completely, or resize it. So, for example, if you felt that a particular column was important to you, that you wanted it nearer the start, if you're right, left to right, you might want it nearer the left, for example. Or if you wanted it larger, then you could resize it. Or if you didn't want it at all, you could remove it. There is a reset columns button so you can play with it and you can go back to whatever the administrator has set for you as a default. So this will be very powerful for enabling you, the teacher, as an individual, to set up the question bank how you want it. Now, we're finishing with other, but there are a lot of other, as you can see. But sometimes some of the other, as I call them, are my favorite improvements or new features. So we have, and I'm not going to read them, but we have improvements to the course index, books, text and media, H5P, database, and groups, how you manage groups. And then a couple of small features that it's useful for you to know about, even though you may or may not use them. Okay, in the course index now, when you go to a Moodle 4.3 site, you'll see three dots that allow you to expand or collapse all of the sections in the course index, similar to what you can already do on the main course page with the words collapse, expand, all. Now, the next one is related to books. And this is something that we've been using in Moodle Academy for a couple of years now. And that's the navigation, how you navigate through the different chapters, they're called. Some people think of them as pages of a book. And we have these neat arrows. And actually, if you have a very long chapter or page in a book with a lot of text, as in my example, which isn't necessarily very accessible, but never mind, then you still have the navigation buttons. So you can scroll up and down, but you'll still be able to navigate from one to another. So that's now from Academy that's been added into Moodle LMS Core. And I hope you like that. And if you're a fan of H5P, if you go into the content bank, then and you click on an existing H5P activity, you now have the option in more, yet again, to copy the content. Click copy the content. You can change its name. And when you save changes, well, you've basically got it copied so you can adapt it for your own needs. I think this is very, very useful if you have similar but not the same activities in H5P in your content bank. Now, text and media area, formerly known as label, it appears in the course index, but sometimes previously the way it appeared wasn't particularly friendly or accessible. So now when you go to add a new text and media area, you have the option to give it a name. Perhaps a better word is title in the course index, because whatever you type here, we've typed Rodin's The Thinker, because this is a public domain image of Rodin, statue of Rodin. And if we save our text and media area, you see that here it actually says Rodin's The Thinker. And so here is the words that we added so that we have a nice readable name in the text and media title in the text and in the course index. Apologies. Now, this relates to database. If you're a fan of database and you like exporting entries, maybe exporting entries to MoodleNet, then you can now include files, database files in your export. Now, the next two features relates to group enhancements. So if you are making a lot of groups, maybe you're auto-creating groups in your course, then you can, in bulk, you can enable or disable group messaging, assuming this is already enabled site-wide by the admin. That will make your life very easy. And also, the administrator now is able to create custom fields for groups and groupings. So if this is of use to you in a teacher, then again, when you're creating your groups, you'll have a drop down to select a custom fields. This might not apply to many of you, but for some people, this might be a useful feature to know about. And this is similar to the last two, which I want to tell you about. They are just small changes, but for some people, they might be very, very helpful. So an administrator can enable a couple of new scheduled tasks, which as a course teacher, you don't have to be concerned with. But what it means is that then, as a course teacher, when you have a new course, the students will not be able to see it until the start date of the course, and or they will not be able to see it when the course ends. So this is only if the administrator enables these two scheduled tasks to show this. And as a teacher, you'll know that because if you click on one of these help icons, you've actually got some extra words, the date when the course becomes visible to students. Before this date, they won't be able to access the course. Or after the date that it ends, they won't be able to access it. So I'm just telling you that so you have as much detail as possible about what's new in Moodle 4.3. And the final thing is, if in your course you like to change the names of teacher and student. Now, of course, an administrator can do this for everyone. But if you in your course, if you wanted to change your name to coach, for instance, or tutor, you wanted to change the word student to learner or pupil or whatever, then the place to do it now is from the participants link, enrolled users, role renaming. You used to do this. When you set up your course in settings, it's moved. So just so you are aware, so you don't get lost trying to find it if it's important to you. And that is a lot of other. So I'm going to stop and I'm going to pass over to Helen to see what discussions and questions have been going on.
Thanks, Mary. There's been quite a few questions. Let me just scroll up the chat to where we are. Okay, so Frank was asking, does the Tiny MC editor in 4.3 include accessibility functionality? And I replied, yes, there's a accessibility checker. Mm-hmm. Then Omid is asking mentioning in 4.1, the type of activity is shown on the course page, like forum. Mm-hmm. But he didn't see it in 4.3. And Scott kindly answered that that was hidden in 4.2.
That's right.
And I think it's, if I'm right, it's shown for teachers, is it?
It shows the teachers when they're in edit mode. I believe also that it is hidden in later versions of 4.1 as well.
Ah, yes.
So if you upgrade 4.1 or 4.0 to the latest versions, you do not see those as a student or a teacher in non-edit mode as well.
Right. And then I've got a question about the video recording. Definitely, if you like to watch this again, it will be available in the 4.3 course on the Academy site.
That's right.
What else? Scott comments about the activity completion settings changes. I think that's the disclosure, gradual disclosure, it's called. Yeah, makes it much easier. And Scott's also asking about the old chat activity, if it's still available. And yes, it is. Kanju is asking whether you can use WhatsApp for a custom link. And the answer is yes.
Then I think you can use any messaging service that allows you to have a URL to a room. I actually tried to use WhatsApp, but I couldn't find a URL that directly linked to a room, but that could well be me not being able to. But if you can, then yes, you can.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, that's a good point. You definitely can for Telegram. And I think for Teams as well.
Oh, yes, that's right.
But yeah, that's a good point. I never checked for WhatsApp, actually. I just guessed. I don't know if anyone else here can confirm one way or the other.
Yeah.
Then Scott was asking about LTI external tools, whether you can give them different icons. And I replied that yes, you can. It's that area of external tools has not been changed since previous versions. And Thomas confirmed that. Scott is commenting that he loves those navigation arrows in the book. And then a question about the label or text immediate area, whether you can remove it from the course index completely. And the answer is no. This is partly because previous research, there were a lot of people saying that they wanted it in their course index, because depending on how you use it, if you have a long course and you want to navigate easily, then it makes sense to keep it in the course index. But it doesn't actually work if you don't fill in that name field to try and not make it show. All that happens is it will be the same as in 4.2, which means the first bit of your text will be used as the title in the course index.
There. Yeah, thanks. I forgot to mention that when I was talking about text and media areas. So thanks for reminding us of that. Yes.
Right. Okay. A few new questions now. One from Pierre asking, would it be possible to filter on custom fields and or tags in questions in the question bank?
I thought you could already filter on tags, can't you? I'm not sure of the answer to that. But I thought you could already filter on tags in questions, yes.
Yeah, I'd have to have a look myself. I don't know offhand. Alex is asking, will a communication icon appear in Classic Theme? And the answer is yes, it's the same in Classic or in Boost. But remember, if you want to use communication feature, it's currently experimental. So as a site admin, you need to enable it first of all.
There is one of the videos, the release videos, is all about communication and does take you to experimental settings to make sure you remember to enable that. Yes. Likewise with MoodleNet, there's a video about MoodleNet showing you how to enable that so that teachers can share courses. I'm just looking at the chat and Omid says, yes, there is a link for WhatsApp groups. So I need to go and practice again because I couldn't find it myself. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's very helpful when other participants in this webinar come up with answers. And remember always, if you have any questions after the webinar's finished, you can always go to Moodle.org, to the forums, and ask in the forums there, and we'll try and help. One more question from Mohammed asking, what's the difference between activity completion passed and complete in a SCORM in Moodle 4.3? Well, as far as I know, nothing's changed in 4.3 compared with how it was before. If you're unsure, then there's a forum, especially for all questions about SCORM on Moodle.org, which is the best place to ask that.
Before we finish, and we're very good for time here, I'll just say a couple of things, which is we'd love you to help to grow Moodle Academy, and we'd love you to get involved in some ways. We have a course called Get Involved. It's on the front page of the Academy site where we'd like you to suggest topic ideas, or why not suggest yourself to present webinars and help create courses on Moodle Academy. That would be great too. We're currently going through the latest list of people who volunteered themselves and getting in contact with some. And we'd love you also to take the course called Translate Moodle Academy so you can translate courses into your language so we are more inclusive. We already have courses translated in Dutch, for example, in French and Spanish. So it would be really good to have our courses in languages other than English, speaking as a linguist myself. And please spread the word. So if you complete courses on Moodle Academy, you can earn badges. This webinar is in a course, What's New in Moodle 4.3, and you can actually earn two badges. You can earn a badge if you do the What's New for Administrators section. You can earn a badge if you do the What's New for Educators section. You only need to earn one if you want, but if you want to earn both, you're more than welcome to. And please tell others about Moodle Academy. All our courses are free. And if you are an educator and you're experienced, why not take our quiz to check if you're ready to do the Moodle Educator Certification, which is a program for experienced Moodlers to get certified by Moodle HQ, and it's run by our Moodle partners, certified service providers. And that's it. So I'd just like to say then, thank you very much for attending. We've had a large number of people asking lots of questions, which is what we really appreciate. So I'm going to stop the recording in a moment. So it's goodbye from me, Mary Cooch.
And goodbye from me, Hannah Foster.
Goodbye.